Christmas, happy holidays. Today is a Christmas day and I have for you preview for the last workout of this year. So we're gonna be doing 365 rep workout. We're gonna do this workout together on Thursday in the real time. And now I'm just gonna go over each exercise in this workout so that you're ready, so that you know exactly what we're doing on Thursday. So I'm gonna start with the exercises for which you're gonna need your dumbbells. I'm using 8-pound dumbbells. And the weight of your dumbbells depends on your own strength, on your own fitness level. So if you're a beginner, you want to start with lighter dumbbells. So first I'm going to show you dragon backward lunge. We're going to be alternating sides. So you start with your feet about hip width apart. You're going to be holding your dumbbells. And now keep your back straight, abs tight, and you're going to lunge back, but across your body, diagonally, backwards, and then back into the starting position. And then you're going to alternate the side, same thing, so you go backwards, but you're going diagonally. And then stand up. You have to be really pushing off of the front heel, push through that heel, and really squeeze your butt and all of the muscles in your standing leg. And that's it, so just make sure that you're not bending your back, that you're not rounding your back. Keep your back straight and shoulders up and down, down and back, and chest up. It's holidays! I just have a really good mood, so let's move on. So bring your weights up like this. Your feet should be about shoulder width apart. Your toes and knees pointing slightly outwards. You're gonna squat down, but you're gonna do a step sideways at the same time. So you're gonna do the sumo squat with a step to the side. So you're gonna bring your butt down, keeping your back straight, get your thighs parallel to the ground, and then back into the starting position. And you're gonna alternate the sides. So again, step sideways, squat down, and back. Like this. Again, keep your back straight, abs tight, shoulders back and down, just up. And that's it. So let's move on to the next exercise, is lunge press. So you're going to start in the starting position. In the lunge position, the front knee is straight just like your toes. It's a 90 degree angle, thighs parallel to the ground. Now, you know, if your left knee is in the front, your right arm is going to be ready to press up. So you're going to start in this position, and then as you stand up, you're going to press the dumbbell up. And then down. And down. This exercise is really challenging, even for me, because it requires to keep all of the muscles in your body working, you know, because it requires a lot of balance. So this exercise definitely improves your balance. If it's really hard for you, then I suggest you put the other way down and you hold on to a chair or something for your support. So you can do the exercise like this. It's up to you. And then we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So you're gonna switch. And that's it. So always remember, keep your chest up, shoulders back and down, core tight. And let's move on. The next exercise with the dumbbell is gonna be dumbbell swing. So you start with your feet a little bit wider apart, and you're gonna use just one dumbbell. You know, swing the dumbbell in between your legs and then up, forward. And you're keeping the arm straight the entire time. And you're trying to, when you swing forward, you want to get the arm like this, straight, parallel with your shoulder. Not down like this, just this, straight. And you want to push your hips forward. When you swing the dumbbell. So back and forward, and really push your hips. All of the power should go from your hips. You should be really propelling your hips forward for when you're doing this exercise. So it's not just your arm that it's swinging the dumbbells, it's your entire body. Like that. And you're gonna do the same thing on the other side, on the other hand. Now, when you're bending over, when you're pushing your hips back, make sure that you should never round your back. Keep your back straight. Keep your abs tight. And that's it. Let's move on. The last standing exercise in this workout is going to be jump squat. That's super easy. So you start with your feet about shoulder width apart. You're going to squat down, push your hips back, keep your back straight, and you're going to jump up as high as you can. That's super easy. And now we're going to move on. We're going to go down on the exercise mat because all of the rest of the exercises are down on the floor. So the next exercise is reptile push-up, and you want to start all the way down on your belly with your hands underneath your shoulders. And as when you press up, you want to do this knee tuck from the outside. You want to look at your knee when you do the knee tuck. And then you go all the way down again. Your belly touches the ground. And then you're going to press up and do the knee tuck on the other side. And down. Now, if you're a beginner, it might be too challenging for you. So just first try to get at least on your knees. Then try to get into the plank and do a little knee tuck at least. You know, just try your best. If you're a beginner, you know, obviously you're not going to be able to do this exercise the way I do it, but with a little bit of modifications, you can, you know, get there. Over time, you're going to build your strength. So let's move on. Another exercise is side crunch. So you're going to lay down on your side, bring one hand behind your head, and now your goal is to bring your knees up towards the elbow and the elbow up towards your knees. So at the same time, you're going to do this. So you're bringing your shoulder off of the ground and your knees off of the ground. And you're going to do the same thing on the other side. So the next exercise is strict mountain climbers. So the strict mountain climbers look like this. You're going to start with your foot next to your hand. And now as you jump, you're going to switch legs. And again, try to jump as far as you can so that the foot always lands next to your hands. Okay, that's it. Keep your core tight. This is a great exercise, great cardio, and amazing exercise for your core. So the next exercise are knee hugs. So what you're going to do is you're going to sit up and you're going to hug your knees. And then lay back down. If you're not really challenged in this exercise, don't bring your legs completely down. Keep them off of the ground the whole time. And keep up the pace. And that's it. And there's actually one last exercise that we're going to do on the floor, and that's a spider. So you're going to be in the plank with your feet a little bit wider apart, and now you're going to be bringing your right foot underneath your body to the left, and you're gonna go right to your right to next to your left hand, and then back down, and then the same thing on the other side. So left foot goes next to your right hand and back. Now if you do this exercise slowly, it doesn't feel like you know, it's hard or anything, but the goal here is to really keep up the pace. So you're gonna go this way really fast. So, I covered every exercise in this workout. So, now it's just up to you to try it at home, you know, and get ready for Thursday, because Thursday we're going to do this workout together. It's going to be really, really hard, but we're going to push through it. So, if you want to get workouts Zivau every week, subscribe to my channel. And you can also visit my website zuzkalaj.com, because, you know, I have all kinds of recipes for you guys. And holidays is all about eating, and I made the effort to come up with makeover recipes so that we can eat, enjoy the holidays, but not feel guilty about it, and also not overload with sugar and all the bad stuff. So check out my site, and I'll see you guys next time. Ciao. It was really hard. I did expect that it's gonna be this hard, I have to say. I knew it. I wasn't sure how long it's gonna take, but it was a great workout, like full body workout, and you feel exactly the muscles that you worked out with the exercise before. So if I did side crunches and then I did the competition burpees, I felt the side crunches, I felt the obliques, you know, during the competition burpees. And when I did push-ups, then after, the burpees were hard on my arms. So it was really cool to see how each exercise is just affecting you in different ways. So